Tease is back. Don't worry, we can't stay mad at you.
Except for that one guy who changed the channel. That's right, you. We're watching you. We're watching you!
Okay, calm down. Settle down, Corky. Well, apart, they already rock on their own, in their own band, Sandwich and Pedicab. But together?
They might possibly rock harder. Diego Mapa and Diego Castillo, the Jegos. They stopped by to join us for a threesome. Or was it foursome?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
If I'm on top.
Yeah, I'm like... We're here with the Jegos, Diego Mapa and Diego Castillo, more popularly known as rock stars, but they are now a DJ collective, DJ duo.
Yeah.
Yeah, you guys seem to have like great collaboration. Are you lovers?
We not anymore. We used to be, but alas, not anymore. Diego's married with children.
With children. So.
But you guys are definitely double D's.
Double D's.
Inappropriate. I'm sure hit with the guys.
With their summer. For their summer vacation.
Yeah,
we're going on a summer fishing trip. How did you guys meet?
So I have my band Monster Bot before in 97. Tapos may Sandwich na nun na nagbe-build up. Tapos may Sunday, Grabe Sunday sa Mayrix. So dun kami first nag-meet, and then that's where we also first met.
I mean, the relationship has lasted for a long time. When did you guys decide to take it to the next level?
That's a good question. Maybe a couple of years ago. Because Diego and I were also... We started DJ at the same time because we were booked by your bandmate, by Mitch Dulce. Booked us at a club called Manila DJ's Club. Is that right? Manila DJ's Club, which is now defunct. So we got there. We had never DJed in our whole entire lives, but we had our CDs.
Mm-hmm.
So all we were doing was basically segueing one song from the next. So
and that was Flux. That's the name.
The name of the event was Flux. So you'd press play, and then when the song was about to end, you'd press play again, and you'd cue it. That's how we started. But then eventually, Diego started buying gear.
But before, of course, when they booked us, we didn't know anything about DJing.
Parang, zero.
Paano ba yan?
Wow.
Sigurado ba kayo? Parang, okay lang ba kung rock? Kahit ano, kahit ano.
So, walang genre.
Which is yung best part nun. So we could play a zombie song, a Beatles song. We could play
Backstreet Boys.
Fugazi.
Yeah.
And then, so sobrang namin enjoy. Sobrang gustong-gusto talaga namin. Halos every week nandun kami. Mm-hmm. Tapos, halos every month, meron kaming two bookings or ano, kahit isa.
But you guys usually, I mean, before that, you had been making your own music. What was it like using other people's music to perform? And like, ano yung, do you guys have any inspiration or like, do you guys have any idols when it comes to like the music you play or how you spin the music?
Spin.
Ako mahina ang mag-cover. I mean, you know, pakapayin mo ako ng kanta, then we'll play it with the band. Parang, I have a hard time doing that. And then, so, this is my chance to play a track that I can't
otherwise
really physically play.
Yeah. No? Same with me, parang, because I'm not a cover band.
And of course, it's nice to see parang the people, parang, oh, he's listening pala to that. Parang ganun. He's not so stupid after all. He's not like a monkey or anything.
He's not like a monkey.
He's not like a monkey.
So, yun, parang ano, oh, he's dropping a Miles Davis track, or parang he's playing.
He's cultured. Oh my god.
Oh yeah, something like that.
You
so,
you have every right to be pretentious at that. Pag ano ka, look at that. He's doing all that. No, but the funny thing is, parang you. I guess the premise, at least for me, was that kung ano yung pinapakinggan ko sa bahay, like whatever I was doing at home, whatever music I sort of like in my free time, which is obviously not my band.
Mm-hmm.
Then tapos that's at work, eh. So when you get home, so yun lang yung setting lang iba. Instead of me listening to it by myself or maybe with Quark and my friends, i-magnify mo lang yan, mas maraming tao. So hopefully, ang maganda is that you introduce some of the kids to some new music that they would not otherwise have heard. Because kids do come up and say, who is this? Or sino?
Right.
So, nakakaaliw kasi, oh, and then you get to teach them maybe something new that they, maybe mainstream radio won't play these tracks or whatever. So, okay, then.
Well, speaking of mixing, you know, different generations of music and introducing them, are there plans to, you know, even release original mixes for the Diegos, samples of... you know, samples of what you guys do together and put it out there even
more. I've been remixing by my own, yeah, but we haven't done anything
we
together.
We should. You know, the funny thing is, on a live setting, it's almost like you're remixing some of the stuff live. Because if you're playing song A, let's say Jago Mapa's playing a specific song, which all of you guys are familiar with, I can put in the drum track of song B coming through. So parang you're almost like mixing it in a, like remixing it in a different way.
Is it like a game or is it like a plan? Is it like
it's a game?
It's a game
because I want to sabihan it. You're right. So half the sometimes tatawa si Jago, yari ka dito, he'll put in something na okay to, parang you can be cheesy, you can be whatever. Mm-hmm. So and the kids kind of see na nagkakatuwa ang kami kasi may visual aspect ata yung because some DJs it's even boring but just some guy
if it's
like
just
cueing
one
songs. That could be any other face, pero pag kami, nahit naman nagkakatawanan or something. Or
well, nagkakamali.
Nagkakamali. Yun ang madami, madami.
Well, that's true. Kasi, you know, not a lot of people really understand what it takes to be, you know, a good DJ, to show off your talent in DJing. And how can people really appreciate, you know, the things that you guys do on the turntables?
Then, to me, the mark of a good DJ is that when he, whatever music you're playing, the crowd reacts. Kasi you survey it, parang Jago was right, kung Cubao X, meron ibang audience ito. Pag sa Makati kami, parang, oh, alam ko na, ito na ata yung time where you bring in this whatever song. And if they respond accordingly, then I think you've done your job pretty well. Tanggalin mo na yung parang malinis. I mean, yeah, that's also, it's a skill though. That's another thing that people forget. It's a skill set, meaning you have to practice being a DJ past a certain point.
Parang you're the DJ is guessing the feeling of everybody.
That's right.
Parang sometimes you can go wrong parang pag masyadong maingay yung track mo at ay parang pagod na lahat sila. So parang may moment na na when you're gonna bring it down.
And
everybody's
so
you know
relax na ulit before you bring it up again.
Parang ganun. So parang mountains.
Transition. All right, but what is up ahead for the Diegos? What can people expect?
This year we're doing a bunch of bar tours, which it's a product that we're about to be doing, but we cannot divulge it just yet. But we will let you kids know. It's something pretty special. It's a DJ related thing that we're about to like be endorsing, so that's pretty cool.
Were you on the cover of Mega? Was it? No, Metro?
No, only the sleeve.
Only the part inside.
So next step for the Diego's modeling. That I guess that's
modeling
it.
And when you do your record and you need someone to drop, give us a sample.
Yeah.
Ginger.
What's it?
The Diego's.
3, 2, 1, and.
I die for the Diego's.
I don't know. And if you need like a DJ guy, like, yo, listen, what's up, what's up? Yo, listen to the
MC.
Yeah,
let's call it MC.
I need to pee.
You've been going on way too much lately, Quark. Guys, thank you so much.
Thank you for having us.
It's been a pleasure, and look forward to seeing the both of you guys on the ones and twos.
Yes. Dropping left those field. Decks.
The left field.
Off left field. Wiki Wiki.
We can't possibly capture everything about our guests in one interview.
So we have the lightning round. We assault our guests with as many questions as songs have remixes.
And they answer as fast as they can. Lightning strikes more than once. Here we go.
Okay, number of music files you have?
A lot.
Maybe 10,000.
Okay, number of music files you have combined?
A lot plus 10,000.
Do you own illegal music?
Yes.
How many times have you been mistaken for each other?
Many times.
Who's more handsome?
D-Mups.
Okay, most number of beats per minute you've gotten to in a set?
180.
160 maybe.
Number of vinyl records you own?
Less than 300.
Same.
Number of drinks you can consume in a set?
More than 10.
On a good set, more than 10.
Are there DJ groupies?
None. No.
Blank Willow.
Pussy.
Blanca Doodle Doo.
Cock.
All right. Favorite dance move?
Picking grapes.
What's that like?
Roger Rabbit.
Favorite dance move that should return?
D.O.M. and Clutch Bag.
How's that like?
Do that. Four on the floor, please.
And you're?
Butterfly.
Do you wear coordinated costumes?
No.
No.
DJ accessory of choice?
Splitter.
Headphone splitter.
A headphone splitter. Because we DJ together, so we need, you know.
Me and Kayo share?
Yes.
Before.
Before.
How long should the set be?
2 hours.
Burn down the house or raise the roof?
Wow.
Raise the roof.
Raise the roof?
Song that's stuck on loop.
Tomorrow Never Knows.
Best opening song?
Overture, Jesus Christ Superstar.
Theme song from The Good, The Bad, The Ugly.
Best closing song.
Who let Marvin, the dogs out?
Marvin Gaye.
Let's get it on.
Let's get it on.
Oh, get that.
All right.